Felicitations, Google Class. Greetings in the spirit. How's it going? I'm Cherry Bell, and I'm vlogging about the big story of SES, science, technology, and society as a student nurse / online ESL teacher vlogger. Now, what's the big idea of SES in nursing or in the English language? You can comment down below what you think, but in my perspective, as a student nurse / online ESL teacher, there's a big link between SES, nursing, and online English teaching. They're all interconnected or interrelated. From a scientific perspective, nursing is based on health science, whilst English communication stems from linguistic humanities or social science. The medium of instruction of nursing in the Philippines is English, as much as healthcare is as universal as the English language, which would enable us to collaborate and interact effectively with each other either online or offline. Aided by technology, benefiting our health and communication skills in order for us to thrive or survive in society as precious individuals. And what better way to give us more in-depth insight about nursing through the lens of SES than to interview an actual nurse, none other than my gorgeous mother from Ireland.
Mom, how have you been?
I'm good. How are you, Cheryl?
I'm good as well. Still doing my best in nursing school. Okay, so right now I'm just calling you from the Philippines since you're there in Ireland. I'm calling you to ask you a few questions about your nursing profession as a student nurse blogger. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, now let me just start off. How long have you been in service as a nurse?
I started working as a nurse, a newly qualified nurse, when I was in my early 20s. And I've been working as a staff nurse in a regional training hospital in Governor D.C., in Canales Memorial Hospital for more than 8 years. And then I went abroad, and since that time, I'm still here working as a nurse. Mm-hmm. And I'm a senior enhanced nurse in the HSC in the hospital here in Northern Ireland.
Oh, great. So you've been a nurse for the past 2 decades, I see.
I think about that.
Around almost 3 decades. Oh, well, thank you very much for your service, Mom. All right, as we all know, science and technology defines society. Science and technology defines life. Science and technology is determined by society. Now, can I ask you, what is the big story of SES to you as a nurse?
For me, this modern advanced technology is really helpful in the nursing career, and this advancement of technology makes our work more efficient and helps us with time management, make our job more quicker, and so we can have more time in the bedside and more quality time with our patients.
I see. So basically, there's been advancements of tools, equipments, and systems.
Yeah, it's true.
Oh, very good. And I think ever since the past few years, Dr. has been aiming to have a more digitalized healthcare field, right?
Yeah, we do.
That's very good. And have you really been tangibly experiencing that as a nurse in Dublin?
Oh, yeah. It's really helpful. Like continuing learning about advanced technology at the time or send for training to attend how to manage this pump or any of the electronic devices that we're using as part of like the equipment
that
help us as a nurse.
Well, that's great. They've also been training you at the same time how to operate those newly digitalized machines, right?
Yeah.
For a more efficient technological environment of work, right? Now, for you, the next question, how can you compare healthcare between two countries as a dynamic and phenomenal nurse?
Oh, it was a lot different because when I was a qualified nurse, that was, I think, during the 1990s, and we're not really in the advanced technology. We're on the laid back, we are doing it manually, and we do a lot of improvised systems, and we have to be resourceful, and we really have to do it very manually. We don't have all this, equipment. So I compare nowadays, and I believe also in the Philippines it's still the same, for more advanced technology and equipment. So it makes our work more efficient, it helps a lot. It makes our job more easier.
Very good. You can focus more on being patient-centered, right?
Oh yeah, time management is what we have to do is through the machine and all this kind of thing. So we have more time, quality time to be with our patients.
Great. So basically there have been improvements, enhancements, modifications of tools, equipment, resources, and systems over the years, right?
Yeah.
Now, next question. How has SES impacted your nursing career for the past 3 decades, and especially during the pandemic?
Oh, It helps a lot, this advancement technology in our nursing career, and especially this pandemic. And like, it would be impossible to be having a face-to-face contact with any other person or your colleague.
Oh yes, even social distance.
Yeah, even to the nursing administration. So this, like the computer, we're using electronic reporting. Mm-hmm. We don't need to go to the office to submit our report. We can do that over using the computer. And even scheduling and even requisition of medication, medical equipment, supplies and everything, we can do it electronically.
Oh, good. Yes.
Yeah. So that helps a lot, especially this challenging time of the pandemic. It helps a lot for us.
That's great.
Distancing, because instead of doing it physically, we can do it through electronically.
Oh, I see. So technology has definitely made a difference in making the healthcare job more convenient, time efficient, and especially in the fields of communication between nurses towards the case or the health status of their patients, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So the nurse can be more holistic and scientifically compassionate to be able to provide ideal healthcare through the from convenient technology. Now, to wrap up, Mom, let me ask you the last question. All right, how do you think SES can improve more in the healthcare or for the healthy lifestyles of people or the nursing field, especially during these challenging times?
And these challenging times, we and the nursing field has a great impact, even to the society, to the people, with our health education in the region, everywhere, like promoting health. And with this pandemic, more people are health conscious to be keeping themselves healthy, to have good immune system and good relaxation, even walking in the park, and even just going around. And it helps, even though despite the pandemic, it makes all of us, the people, make
we're all healthy. Involved.
We're all involved. Oh, yes. It's everybody's.
We're all affected.
Cooperation. Everybody's cooperation.
We all have to collaborate, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and is that all?
Yeah, I know this is the most challenging time of the history, I think. And even in my nursing career, I never experienced so much challenging. This is my
first time.
Challenging time in my nursing career. Like I oftentimes, I feel like I have the fear of the unknown, especially during the height of the pandemic. And would you believe there are only 5 of us left who didn't contract the COVID, and sometimes
we congratulations.
Just to cover up the shift, just to cover up
the staffing.
Who is out sick?
No. Well,
it's not really easy, but it's more about being healthy, and also you have to maintain your mental health. Mental health is very important at this challenging time. But
bear that in mind.
Being a nurse is really helpful, because you're still a nurse, whether you are, at home, everywhere, you still remain as a nurse, and this advanced technology helps a lot. Like now, we can do Zoom calls or Skype calls to communicate.
Oh, yes.
So this pandemic is also a positive way of getting each other close, connecting to each
digitally.
Other.
Digitally. Yes, yeah. I'm even doing part-time online ESL teaching.
Yeah, very good,
Cheryl.
So proud of you.
Thank you. Well, thank you very much, Mom, for your time. Our hearts definitely go out to everyone in the world affected with this challenging pandemic situation. And no worries, because this is temporary, right, Mom? Pandemic is temporary.
I greatly believe, and as a matter of fact, I even commit myself for the vaccination rollout. And by next week, I'll be starting to do the vaccination. Hopefully, everything will go back to normal. And see you again.
Thank you, Mom.
And
sorry for that.
As well. Being a nurse, you will also be a successful nurse in the future.
Thank you. Thank you for your great advice as a student nurse blogger. And well, just hang in there, Mom. We know we can all go through this. And to all your colleagues, send my best regards.
All right. Thank you, Cheryl. You're so good. I love you.
Love you too. Thank you for participating in my blog.
Thanks so much.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.